Join Big Nose, the hysterical prehistoric hero in a madcap chase speeding through prehistoric landscapes on his invention, the wheel. Race through fire worlds of hills and slopes, perform death-defying leaps, clearing a path through an army of prehistoric monsters. Discover secret levels, special bonuses, and more. But beware, it's a jungle out there. This is Big Nose Freaks Out from Codemasters and Comerica, released in 1992. Like many Codemasters titles, it was also released for the Aladdin Deck Enhancer. We control a caveman character who has had all of his bones stolen from the prehistoric bank by a dinosaur. Big Nose sets off on an adventure through numerous prehistoric settings. We defeat enemies using a club. However, we have access to a primitive skateboarding device, stoneboarding, via his invention, the wheel. The game is essentially a platform game in which the player collects bones and other items while traveling from left to right until reaching the goal. Big Nose Freaks Out also had a two-player mode and the addition of numerous secret levels and bonuses. Big Nose Freaks Out has become popular as more people have access to the ROM file through emulation websites. This is very, very much like Sonic to me. I get a very, very strong Sonic vibe out of this. It's not altogether a bad game. According to the box, this was a 2-meg cart. I don't see where a lot of that meg went, unless the game is 18 hours long. Graphics aren't too bad, but you can kind of get an idea of what everything is. The levels are fairly expansive and give you a little room to explore. The music is weird, as it just kind of, when it's there, it's not very good, and then it's just gone. So I guess that's a benefit, I suppose. It was actually kind of fun to play. Not a fan of Sonic, not a fan of Sonic-esque games, but it was kind of fun to play. And this actual style of gameplay, going through the level left to right and picking up bones and being able to backtrack and all this other stuff, became kind of a staple in a lot of Genesis and SNES games, too. So, Big Nose Freaks Out. Well, not incredibly groundbreaking in 1992. No, not too bad. I'd give it a C.